Hi everyone, and welcome back to the Popcorn Effects channel. In this tutorial, we're going to cover billboard rotations. Rotating a billboard is a very handy way to break the silhouette and give some motion to an effect. In the billboard node, there's a rotation field property that has the name of the field holding the billboard's rotation angle. It is set by default to use the field named rotation that we're going to create right now to be able to use it. It must be a float variable because this value holds the rotation angle. When the rotation field is created, we can assign its value using the script. And now, we'll be changing the initial rotation of the billboard in the spawner script. Popcorn Effect expects angles to be in radians, not degrees. So if you're more comfortable using degrees, feel free to use the degrees to radians function. Over here, we are setting the initial rotation to be random between minus 180 and 180 degrees. That's how we randomly rotate the billboards at spawn. And for the techie people, we'll use the pi constant in radian. To achieve the same behavior, but this time with fancy methods coding. To rotate our billboard over time, we'll use the rotation evolver. All we have to do is simply right-click on evolvers and select the rotation evolver. In the rotation evolver, the scalar rotation speed property is enabled by default. And when we create this evolver, a scalar rotation speed field is automatically added to the fields. In this way, we can use it directly in the script. Now we'll go back to the spawner script and set the scalar rotation speed to a random value between minus 3 and 3. Now, our particles are rotating between minus 3 and 3 radians per second. Beautiful. The rotation evolver allows us to use another rotation mode. By default, it's set to screen space. It means the scalar rotation speed rotates the billboard depending on the billboard's face direction. Let's explain this on the Popcorn Effects board. So this is a billboard facing the camera. And the line in pink represents the billboard's face direction. So when the billboard rotates, it's going to rotate around this axis. So it can be rotating in this direction or the other. Another example of when the billboard isn't facing the camera, like a planar billboard. Same idea, this is the billboard face direction, and it rotates around that axis, one way or the other. Another example, it rotates around this way or the other way. And there's the final example, and I suppose you got the idea. It rotates around the face direction in one direction or the other. Now we'll show the example of the axial rotation mode. Starting from a new effect, we'll add the rotation evolver. Change the rotation mode to axial mode, and then set the rotation speed vector to axis forward, or flow 3 side forward up 0 and 0. And we'll change the camera view, and notice that it's view dependent. By the way, the lines in green are the rotation speed vectors. And this is another call for the Popcorn Effects board. To put it in a simple way, the speed of the rotation in radius per second is the length of the rotation speed vector multiplied by the dot product of the normalized rotation speed vector and the camera view. Here's the scenario. We have camera facing billboards and the camera that will rotate around the billboard. The reddish-orange arrow is the vector of where the camera is facing. The green one is the billboard's face direction, and the pinkish vector is the rotation speed vector that we defined as axis forward, meaning that it's fixed and it's not going to change. So what's going to happen in state 1? The camera vector is going to be aligned with the rotation speed vector, forming a 180 degrees between them, meaning that their dot product is minus 1. So the speed of the rotation is going to be minus 1 radians per second. Since the length of the rotation speed vector is 1. In case 2, the camera forward axis is going to form 180 degrees minus x, meaning that their dot product will be between minus 1 and 0. So the rotation speed is going to be slower than what it was in case 1. And finally, in case 3, the camera view vector is going to be perpendicular to the rotation speed, forming a 90 degrees between the vectors, making their dot product 0. Which means that the billboards won't rotate. Back to the example, I'm going to multiply the rotation speed by 2 and by pi to get a 360 degrees rotation when the camera is aligned with the rotation speed vector and becomes 0 when perpendicular with it. One of the best ways to use this feature is in the following example. These can be clouds or dust formed by a thruster. In this example, we used the cross product between the velocity and the scene axis up and plugged it in the rotation speed field so that our particles spin perpendicularly to their velocity vector. I'll turn on debug mode to have a visual of these vectors. So the green vectors are the velocity and the red ones are scene axis up. I change it to minus scene axis up to change the direction of the rotation. This way, when the air pushes the clouds, they rotate to the inside. Rotation speed is their cross product. That is represented by these blue vectors. I'll only keep the rotation speed debug on and turn off the others. So now the rotation speed vector is in green. As you can see, when the camera forward axis is aligned with the rotation speed vector, we have the maximum rotation speed. Otherwise, the rotation speed is not at maximum, creating this lovely mushroom vortex rotation effect. If you have any other ideas of when to use axial mode, feel free to share them in the comments below. Well, this wraps things up for our video. Don't forget to like and share if you found it helpful, and subscribe to our channel for more videos and tutorials. Thank you for watching.